Hey humans, this is Angel here. I am calling to let you know that I was thinking about home cooking lately. I know personally, I have these moments where I'm home cooking all the time, and then I have these moments where I just want to eat out all the time, because I don't want to cook a thing, and I don't want to even like bother, and it's, you know, we all go through these ebbs and flows of life, right? So I think to keep each other accountable, I'm going to propose a challenge, and it's going to be called It's Home Cooking Good Looking, and you're just basically getting a hashtag whenever you cook a meal, post it to social media so that I can check in on you guys and see how you guys are doing and seeing if you guys are home cooking with me. And also along with that, with my newsletter, I'm going to provide some recipes. Ooh, we love recipes, right? on different things that you could be cooking at home. A lot of it's going to be plant-based. I will have a couple of meat options just because my husband really likes meat, and he bought some on sale, so now I have to find ways to cook it, and I personally don't like touching it, but you know, there's a first for everything. So I'm gonna go ahead and do that, and then I will send each recipe that I do for the next 2 weeks, guys. I'm committing to you for 2 weeks of home cooking, and that's like huge for me personally. So if you guys could work alongside with me and we can motivate each other, and if you guys want to start a Facebook Messenger group, I am totally open to that. If you guys are open to that, go ahead and reply to this newsletter, to my email, coaching@angelsamsa.com, and let me know if you want to start like a Messenger group, and then I can send my recipes that I have every day through there. Or we can do a newsletter. So send me which way you'd want me to maybe start sharing my recipes with you. And we can get that going. And it'll be hashtag It's Home Cooking Good Looking. And it's going to be great. So home cooking can be hard for everyone. I think it's one of those things that it's all a skill. I know I couldn't really cook before I got married and starting to have to really kind of cook and like serve myself, really not having to depend on someone else to kind of cook it for me. Or when I was single, I ate out a lot. So, you know, it's one of those things you have to learn at some point in your life. I know even if you suck at this point, I still kind of suck with certain things. There are certain things that I still struggle to make, but it all comes with practice, and we have to not get discouraged, because I know I have gotten discouraged about cooking so many times, and honestly, that's a big reason why I don't home cook a lot of the time, is because of how discouraged I can get sometimes, especially when something doesn't come out right. You spend hours and hours grueling over a stove and a bowl and a knife and a cutting board and all that craziness, and then nothing really comes out right, and it's really frustrating, and you're like, why would I even bother with this? That restaurant down the street is way cheaper. I didn't have to waste the food that it gave me, and it's delicious, and I know it's going to be delicious, and that's what I can count on. I know, but you know, imagine you do create those recipes that you absolutely love and can eat all the time, that are healthy for you, that are nourishing for your body, that are whole foods. And you know exactly what's going in the food, you know exactly what's going into your body, and honestly, don't you ever wonder about what happens behind closed doors? Like, I know personally, things happen in the kitchen, and I would hope that things are dealt with properly, but you can't ever make that guarantee. So why wouldn't you want that own guarantee in your own kitchen, in your own space, and with your own two hands? You put the love in, because energy does transfer into food, guys. If you didn't know, when people say, I added love, it actually does. Like, there's been certain things to test these things. Differences, like I have heard of a personal story that somebody grew these oranges in her garden, and she took half the orange from the same orange, half the orange, and spoke good intentions into it, and then the other half, she just didn't do anything. And then so then she would go to her friends and family and ask them which piece of orange would taste better without telling them what she even did or where it came from, and they would always say that the one with the good intentions always tasted better. Like, She said like 90-something percent of the time it was like accurate, that the ones that they liked the most and said was the most delicious was a good intentioned one. So just keep that in mind, guys. Like when you are upset and you are cooking, that will go into your food. When you're happy and you're excited and you're full of love, that will go into your food. So these are things to just consider, things that I never considered until kind of recently. We will go more over food choices and things like that eventually, but if you are ever curious about dietary choices specifically for your body, I do have free consultations set up. So if you want to go to my website, angelshamsa.com, there's a booking tool under, I think it's like the contact me or something along those lines, and you can go ahead and sign up for a free consultation with me, and we can maybe discuss dietary goals. Maybe if you're confused on certain food choices for your body, we can talk about that. We can figure out how to sort all through these things about food that there's so much information out there, guys, and you have to sort through so much. But lucky for you, I have been to a school where I've learned over 100 dietary theories, and I have heard from tons of doctors and scientists and nutritionists and dietitians and all sorts of people on the pros and cons of different foods, kind of what's good for people's bodies, what's not, for different ailments or illnesses, kind of where to go from there. So I've done all the heavy lifting for you guys. So all you guys need to do is go ahead and sign up on my website, which I've made it super easy to do. I'm pretty flexible. So yeah, keep that in mind. As always, I love you guys. We will contact each other about food another time. Have a great, wonderful day. That was both together. A wonderful day. And I hope to see y'all soon. Bye, humans.